Hello everyone. Hope everyone's safe at home. Miss Hatcher made you a great video last week, and so it's my turn this week. And so what I thought I'd do is I'd read you one of my favourite stories that I've loved reading with my children at home over many years. And I think you'll all agree it's going to be a really funny video. So on the telly behind me, I've got all the images from the book so that you can see them as I read along. And this story is the dinosaur that pooped a planet. So wait till you see this and you're going to see a brilliant story about a crazy boy named Danny and his pet dinosaur. So is everyone ready? Let's go. So, The Dinosaur That Pooped a Planet by Tom Fercher and Dougie Pointer. Danny and his dinosaur liked to have fun. Some days they had lots and some days they had none. One day they were bored. They had no games to play. Danny said, "Dinosaur, what shall we do today? We could mow the lawn, we could tidy the place, we could do our chores, or we could go to space." "But you mustn't forget to have lunch," said their mummy. "You cannot have fun without food in your tummy." So they packed a packed lunch for the Science Museum, where rockets were kept, if you wanted to see them. There were hundreds of rockets and spaceship surprises. Tall ones, small ones, all shapes and sizes. And one that was ready to launch with a door, big enough for a boy and his pet dinosaur. They ignored all the warnings. They couldn't care less. They pressed all the things they shouldn't have pressed. T-minus 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, ignition. And they started their galactic space mission. They flew higher than houses and buildings and cranes, much higher than birds, even higher than planes. "We're in space," Danny yelled as they floated around. But Dinosaur's tongue made a rumbling sound. "It's time to have lunch," Danny looked at his watch. Then they looked all around for the dino's lunchbox. Danny started to worry and started to panic. They've left their packed lunches back on their home planet. So with no food on board, not the smallest of crumbs, a disastrous dinosaur feast had begun. It gobbled up gadgets and gizmos galore. Nothing was safe from the space dinosaur. Robots and ray guns and blinking red blinkers, eating things thought up by NASA's great thinkers. The hyperdrive gamma reactor machine was swallowed along with the space tractor beam. It chewed and it chomped on the spaceship controls. The rocket was dotted with tiny tooth holes. Inside it was bare, the spaceship was empty. Outside there were more things to eat, there was plenty. It broke down the door with a cool ninja chop. Out in space, dinosaurs were much harder to stop. It chomped on the moon like a big chunk of cheese, then shoved even more in its face with a squeeze. It munched on the Martians from Mars and their cats. Their cats are like ours, but they wear cool space hats. Satellites, Saturn and 6 supernovas, shape-shifting saucers and 7 space rovers. It guzzled 5 gallons of fuel from the tank, and Danny's jaw dropped as it watched what it drank. With a crunch and a crack and a nom 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 nom, in one dino gulp, their rocket was gone. Now nothing was left, all Danny could see was a fat dinosaur where the rocket should be. And so they were stranded with no way back home, just Danny and Dino in space, all alone. Now Danny was crying. He cried and he cried. He cried and his tears filled the spacesuit inside. Unless they were going to stay there forever, the dinosaur needed to do something clever. With a feeling of guilt deep down in its gut, its brain brewed up a plan involving its butt. It knew there was only one thing it could do to get them back home. It needed to poo! Like a poo-powered rocket, the dinosaur flew. Dan hopped on its back and he watched as it pooed. It pooped out the rockets and ray guns and blinkers. The things NASA's thinkers thought up were now stinkers. It pooped out the moon, it pooped out the stars, it pooped out the space rovers and the Martians from Mars. When Danny looked back, he could see a poop trail from far out in space from the dinosaur's tail. They headed back to Earth and they started to orbit. It pooped on the clouds, but the clouds just absorbed it. They flew past the buildings and streets of their town, leaving the houses all smelly and brown, and finally landed back down on the ground. Hooray, cried Danny, we're home safe and sound. They looked up to the sky and the things that were pooed had formed a poop planet right next to the moon. And so Danny promised to listen to Mummy, because fun is food, fun without food in its tummy. And all when you thought all the pooping was done, a Mars cat popped out of the dinosaur's bum. I really hoped you enjoyed that, everyone. It's one of my favourite books, and my children have been enjoying it for years. I really hope everyone's safe and sound back home, and we can't wait to see you all soon. So stay safe, take care, and from all of us at St. Nicholas's, we'll see you soon. Bye.